I remember what it was like back then. I was lost. Well, maybe not lost, but certainly adrift. I think of those guys in movies, you know, the starving castaway on a makeshift raft, peering over the tops of waves, looking for land, and just living on hope. Yet somewhere deep inside, I got this crazy idea in my head that I was destined for some kind of greatness. And it wasn't that I wanted to be noticed, it was more like I was just driven to leave some kind of mark on the world. As I recall the events of that summer, there was a deep flurry of excitement going on inside of me. I'm connecting to something that's driven me since birth. It is here and now, in the moment of creating, where I feel the most at ease and confident. It's always felt just right, and it's always brought me a rush of emotions, most of them the best I've ever known. Now, the downside of it is that there's always some jerk-off who stands in judgment of what you do.
You suck.
The harshest criticisms always seem to come from those who truly have no idea of what you're doing, truly have no gifts of their own, and are just plain pissed off that you're happy and happily playing your craft. That is, of course, unless you're making the world a little more ugly. Then that type of personality will gladly hold your hand and dance through a shit-filled sewer, proclaiming that you, just like they, see not only how awful it all is, but take pleasure in the celebration of it. But somewhere early on, I came to understand that any asshole can see how terrible things are. That didn't take any skill. So I'm warning you now that this is an adult story. If you wish to be a cynic, that would be your very unfortunate choice. Cynics are generally right. Romantics are generally wrong. But a romantic needs to be right only once in their life, and that's when they choose their true love. I guess love is what this story is really all about, and maybe it would be best served if that's all I said. But then you wouldn't get to know Nikolai the way I did. And that would be unfair to both of us.
My son?
No, Mr. Talley. Probably up there painting a picture.
What'd you say, Mikey?
Nothing, sir.
Girls,
Now, my dad was a complete and total homophobe. Him catching me playing with these brushes was just about the equivalent of him catching me blowing a friend of mine.
Why do you ask me stuff like that?
You got pictures of all these guys with their things hanging out.
This is a hard thing to do, you know? Draw contours and all the shadowing and... It's not because I'm doing it because, you know, I like the guys. I'm doing it to be a great artist.
Do me a favor. Will you just take your friends down?
Hey, Ma.
Hey, Johnny.
Can you tell me something? What do you think of this? Seriously.
Gotten Himmel. Oh, it's beautiful, Johnny. So, so beautiful.
Really?
Do you have paint on your hands?
No.
Are you sure?
No, I just washed them.
Here. I want you to hold this. Put that down.
Put
this on? Put it up. I want to see how it looks.
You want me to put this on?
No, just hold it. Yeah.
Right here?
Yeah, so I can see what it looks. Oh.
My mother was born in Breslau, Germany. She was 16 when the Allies hit Berlin. She had no childhood to speak of since she was busy ducking shrapnel since the age of 11. She was also a very complicated and tortured woman. Although I know she hated what the Nazis had done to her country, I think she still secretly rooted for the Germans when watching war movies.
It's going to be beautiful. You know you get all your talent from me, darling.
Thank you.
Oh, that's nice. Real nice, John.
Johnny, try not to use so much black. Try to find the colors in these trees. And always try to find colors in the shadows. Purples, blues, greens.
In other words, don't use so much black.
Thank you.
And always look for design. There's design in everything. Come here. You see those telephone poles? Not one of them is straight, especially in good painting. See, one a little bit left, one a little bit right. You see those shadows across the street? You see how they connect to the building mass?
Yeah.
Think in the abstract.
Okay.
I'm gonna frame this up for you.
Yemi, I can't afford gold leaf.
Now, who said I was going to charge you?
No, John, no favors. No favors, you pay the man.
Okay, I got it. Oh, my God.
Mr. Serov.
Oh, I know. I mean, how'd you get a hold of this?
I'm framing it for Joe Catanzaro.
How could a plumber afford a painting like this?
Well, they're not going for as much as they used to.
Why?
It's representational.
So?
It's considered irrelevant.
Well, by who?
Critics. Art magazines.
Fuck that. This is beautiful.
John, what's your language?
What's this worth?
I don't know. Zirov traded it for plumbing work.
Are you serious? He lives near here?
Yeah, up on High Street.
Dad, did you hear that?
Yeah, terrific.
Do you know him?
Well, I don't think anyone really knows him. I've met him a few times.
Really?
If you're thinking about going up there and paying a visit to that old bastard, I wouldn't recommend it.
Is he crazy or something?
Well, he doesn't have much use for people.
You know, I'm not people. I'd love to talk about art.
So now what, John? You're gonna go bother this other poor bastard?
Dad, why do you always think that I'm, like, bothering people?
Because you do.
I'm excited.
This Yamarino guy, is he all right?
Sorry, what does that mean?
Is he all right? He's very touchy. Touchy.
All right, like, is he in a good mood?
No, exactly what I mean. Don't be a smartass.
I don't know what that means. What is that, touchy?
Just shut up.
I still don't follow.
Don't.
Thank you.
Mr. Seroff?
Uh-huh. What do you want? Am I so fucking attractive? You need to stare. You're a smart one. You want to work in the garden? Cut the grass, trees?
No.
What?
Are you Nikolai Seroff?
Oh, shit. Yes, I am.
Read both of your books.
Oh, you did.
I really think you're brilliant.
Oh, I'm brilliant.
Yeah, your use of color. God, what you said about composition, how trees are like nudes dancing on a hillside.
I said that.
Yeah, you also said the trees are kind of like booted men, and never encroaching on each other's space, and that there's a lesson to be learned about nature. No shortage, only abundance.
Oh, yeah. Fuck me. Oh. Nice talking to you, kid.
Nikolai! It's Yami. Yami! Oh, I'm fine. I'm good. Listen, I heard that a friend came by the other day to see you.
Yeah, the kid.
Well, his name is John, and I think he's got a lot of talent. He'd like to come by and just sit with you and talk about painting. Yeah. Okay. Good night. You're not interested.
Not... What did he say?
Well, he was a bit short.
A bit short? Like he's not interested at all?
Now, look, John, I'd forget about this if I were you. As I understand, he's had a lot of problems in his life, and he was one royal pain in the ass in his heyday, so I can imagine what he'd be like now.
This is very good, really. Very good.
Thank you.
Tell me, why us? Why here? I mean, why not Pratt? Parsons School of Design.
Dad?
Huh? What?
I was asking your son if he'd considered Pratt or Parsons.
It's okay. It's okay. He's gonna go here.
Hey, who is it?
Mr. Seroff, I would appreciate it if I could just talk to you for just a moment.
Wait.
Who is it? Young man, you again. What do you want?
First off, I don't want to bother you. I don't mean to. I'm sorry.
It's good that you don't mean to.
I'm wondering if... Do you teach?
I don't teach, and I don't paint.
You know I'm a friend of Vincenzo Iamarino, right?
Uh-huh. So he's done with you? And wants you to be my problem now, correct? I don't trust anyone who doesn't drink.
Really, why is that?
If you don't drink, it means you want to continue hiding in the shadows.
I guess we wouldn't want that, would we?
Oh. So now we are familiar enough to make jokes.
Sorry.
You're not some nitwit looking to waste my time.
Does that mean that you're going to teach me?
No. Go to art school.
I don't teach real painting in art school.
Of course I don't. God forbid they teach something with form or substance.
Or something that makes people feel something.
Feeling is the enemy of the elite. You can't be smarter than them or they crucify you. In my opinion, painting is dead, never to return. Common man has been removed from the process. And why? Common man has common sense, has no time for bullshit. Common man can spot bullshit 10 miles away, and this is why there's no place for him in art of today. A vast conspiracy out there in the world. Not that all these ungifted idiots get together once a week and plot the demise of humanity, no. But believe me, It's a conspiracy, just the same. A journey shared is more deeply moving and experienced than a journey taken alone. Human beings need validation. That's how we learn. We feel something that we are unclear about, and others who have felt something similar. Help points the way. Art that shares is part of the validation to feel. When there is no context, there is no statement. When there is no statement, there is no sharing. When there is no sharing, there is no beauty. No? When there is no beauty, there is no fucking art. If you see beauty everywhere and everything, your soul is set free. No one can take it away. I know this to be true.
How do you know this?
Fuck you, I just do.
All right.
You believe in God?
I think I do.
You say your prayers at night?
Yeah.
You believe you are being heard?
Yeah.
In my opinion, Essex can never be a great painter. In order to create great art, man must make peace with his mortality and bow to a higher power. Job of the artist is to uplift man's soul. Bullshit elite wishes to change all of this. I could wipe my ass with a fucking curtain, have a better chance at hanging Guggenheim than painting the face of a child. It makes you cry.
You have to teach me this stuff. You have to teach me to paint.
No. The world has gone crazy and you will just be miserable.
I'm not doing this to make money.
Good to know.
Okay, what if I just bring some canvases over, you take a look at them and you tell me what you think, real quick?
No, I'm going to Pennsylvania.
Pennsylvania?
Yes.
Why?
Somehow there.
Are you gonna paint?
No, I have a girlfriend, a young blonde tall with big tits.
Really?
Oh, no.
Well, if I just bring a few by before you take off?
Will you stop bothering me after that?
Absolutely.
Absolutely. Good. Tomorrow. Go before I change my mind.
Thank you.
You did this all by yourself? No help whatsoever, no training?
No, no training.
Good, because I would hate to think you paid someone to paint such miserable work. I mean, not that you don't have some talent, but you are seeing things through the eyes of other men. And this one, this tree is okay. But I've seen this fucking tree in 400 paintings. This is a crooked branch you stole from Robert Wood. Correct? What's this? Are these supposed to be clouds or flying rocks? I mean, clouds are not so wide. Come, let's have a look. Do these clouds look white to you?
Yeah.
Fuck you. Yeah. This is white. Look. This is white. Do they still look white to you?
Oh, holy shit. It's it. It's they're warmer. They're, the pink, the yellow, the purple
good,
ridge.
Good. Now pick it up. So, yeah, now get your stuff and go. And I wish you luck. I wish you luck. I thought we had an agreement.
I just wanted to thank you.
Ah, thanks. Just kidding. Come in. Come in. I like this. Guy makes me laugh.
Yeah, my parents like this too. Hey, Mr. Serov?
Stop calling me that. My name is Nikolai.
All right, I'm sorry, Nikolai.
Psst, psst, psst.
All I want to know is if I can go see your studio.
Why?
Well, I'd like to see it.
Yeah, studio's in mothballs.
I can go alone, it's not a big deal. Just point me in the direction.
What?
I can go alone, you don't have to block.
I don't want you poking around up there by yourself. Shit! Now I have no idea what's going on.
Sorry. Yeah.
Oh, let's go, little shit. Come. My vodka, little shit. Look around.
God, I can live up here.
Yeah, you and the mice.
Hey, what are you doing with this canvas?
Take it. I have no use for it.
You can't just take your canvas.
You know, one day, maybe 10 years ago, I read by some idiot. Representation and art is sentimental. Passé. I said to myself, I show you, you fucking idiot. I laid out my paints. I was going to set the world on fire. Say something beautiful, say something special, say something. You know, and then I said, just fuck it. Who gives a shit?
Do you really care what critics think?
Are you fucking with me, you little shit?
No, I just, you don't strike me as the kind of guy who really gives a shit what people think.
Look, this is all very nice, chit-chat. But you're young, and life hasn't kicked the shit out of you yet.
Oh, really? What makes you think I have such an easy life?
You haven't seen the ugliness that people are capable of inflicting on one another. When I painted, I was always aware of the great men who stood in front of the canvases before me. Da Vinci figured out chiaroscuro. I'm sure you don't know what it is.
Light and space, the natural recession of an object as it's affected by light.
Good, good, good. Monet, Pizarro, Renoir. They helped me to see color, mostly secondary colors. I'm sure you don't know what I'm talking about.
Yes, I do.
You do?
Purple, green, orange.
Do you know who Fechin was?
Yes, I do.
Who is he?
He's a Russian artist. He painted in tiles.
Fechin was obsessed with edges. The meeting of two objects in space. Lines are man-made concepts. There are no lines in nature, you know.
I disagree. John Carlson, he said in his book, every edge must be hit hard.
Buff. All right. All right. You teach me something, you little shit.
Van Gogh, Redfield, they outlined everything.
It's true. Making things a bit less natural, in my opinion, more expressive. Life is too short to make some small, wispy paintings. I need to shout I was here. Fuck you! I was here! Here! On this planet! Here!
Quiet. The critics might hear you.
What's the first thing? You examine.
Local color.
Which is?
It's the essence of the thing before it's affected by anything else around it.
Bravo. Very good.
Honestly, Nikolai, I can recite this stuff. I've read it. I know it. But do I know what it means? Can I apply it to my work? No.
No surprise. Wiping your own ass is a recent development for you. But all these things can only be learned by trying. And that's very important. Allowing yourself to fail. There's no secret to this. Just work.
That's it right there. I'm willing to work. You can go on and on about the progression of artists and not help me, as someone has obviously helped you in the past. Is that fair?
All right, all right. What? You can come up to Pennsylvania with me for the summer. If I don't kill you, I teach you paint. If you try to hack me, I'll kill you now.
Okay. Yeah. You're telling me you want to go into the woods with an old man?
Well, yeah. This is a huge, huge opportunity for me.
How's that?
This guy's a Russian master.
Great, he's Russian too. So you come back a communist and who knows what else?
Oh, you gotta let me do this.
No, you're not doing it. Forget it. You're gonna be working with me this summer.
That's bullshit.
Watch it.
You can't hold me back like this.
Johnny, don't talk that way to your father.
I'm sorry, Mom, but you know what? He can't hold me back like this.
John, you are not going into the woods with an old fucking man.
Why not?
What do you mean, why not? Don't be stupid. You know why not. Wake up. You know what this old man wants.
There's really something wrong with you.
No, I hope you play the thing better than you paint. I'm going up there for quiet and don't need to hear horrible noise coming from your room. Takes
all
us
right. Into. I'll keep it down.
tell me, is this okay, Esperance?
Yeah.
You sure?
Yeah, they support this stuff.
Okay, then let's go. You can wash the scars.
Do you want me to drive?
47 summers I've driven without incident.
You sure?
Sure. Get in the car, you little shit. Let's go.
All right, sorry.
In the city where man is king, completely in control of his environment, I imagine it's easy to begin to believe that you rule all. But out here, where you take what nature doles out at its whim and not yours, well, I found it to be freeing. Somehow the pressure was off because I took great comfort in knowing that I mattered so little, and embracing the notion that there was some kind of higher power that may in fact have a plan for me made me settle down inside. Everywhere I looked, I saw paintings, masterpieces paraded through my mind. I felt sad for Nikolai, that his life's work was now considered irrelevant. I couldn't understand how these so-called experts could say anything so completely misinformed. Who gave them the power, or more importantly, the right? How could beauty be irrelevant? With the landscape vanishing before our eyes by the increasing encroachment of man, well, I couldn't think of anything more relevant.
Get the bags. I need to piss. Throw my stuff on my bed. Upstairs to the left.
Okay, well, where should I put my stuff?
In the barn. Kitty, first room on the right. Huh? Comfortable, huh?
Yes.
Isn't it beautiful? You know, this country, it reminds me a bit of home.
Really?
Yeah.
This is what Russia looks like?
St. Petersburg. Baltic Sea. Lead. Like this beautiful. I grew up with two languages. German, Russian. Beautiful. This country. Yeah, beautiful. You know, after German attacked, there was little reason to stay. I was stopped at border by a young German soldier. I think your age. He asked me where I was going. I told him that I was leaving my country, that he had invaded, and I was going to be free. If he didn't like it, he can shoot me. But I wasn't going to stop walking. I kept walking, walking, and never heard a shot.
It's very brave of you.
No, not brave at all. Just too tired to care.
You know, I'm half German.
Oh, you're not going to shoot me. No kidding. Maybe soldier is your great uncle.
Do you miss home?
I don't think about it much. You know, I can't go back.
Well, if you could, would you?
No. I'm an American now, and I love my adopted country.
Really?
Of course I do. You don't?
Yeah, I guess.
You little shit. You have no idea what you have here. In any other country, you'd be down in a salt mine where you belong.
Take it easy there. That's not what I meant. I'm very happy. Happy to be American. Happy to be here with you. I'm so happy to be an American. I'm so happy to be with you. Cause I'm here with a badass impressionistic Russian painter motherfucker. I'm gonna be a badass Russian impressionist. Well, I'll be an American painter motherfucker too.
There's no hope for you.
No hope whatsoever.
Nice, huh? Made from the mist and noise.
One thing that there was no shortage of in my life was fear. I began to realize that I was truly in the middle of nowhere with this guy, and who knows, maybe my father was right. Maybe this old bastard was plotting to attack me.
Just checking if you are comfortable.
Yeah?
Yeah. Good night.
Okay.
I never saw a human being eat as much as Serov did in my life. He would start every morning out with about half a dozen eggs, more than a pound of bacon, and easily six slices of toast with gobs of butter and marmalade and about four cups of coffee. This would be followed by a series of blood pressure pills, heart pills, and something to help keep down his blood sugar. Last but not least, he would pour himself a huge glass of vodka, which he would then continue to do for the rest of the day.
Today, you paint.
How are you, my friend?
Oh,
I'm Curtis Sunday, by the way.
Oh, good.
You look great.
Is this for me?
This is for you. This is for a little me. Return old memory. You have a great turnout to show me?
Oh, yeah. Go ahead.
Come on.
Go ahead.
So the show didn't go as well as I had hoped. I don't know, I could feel a sense of boredom in the patrons. People want to be shocked, you know? They want to be appalled. They want to be held in the grips of their own discomfort.
Is this art show we are talking about? Oh, cancer of the asshole.
Anyway, I have been asked to be on the committee for the Art Barn next month, and I'm also on the hanging committee, and I would like for you to be the judge. Are you interested?
Real painting or bullshit?
Progressive.
So, then, bullshit.
Nikolai, with your classical training and your discerning eye for the truth, you would really be doing me a favor.
Sure. I go, if not at least to laugh.
That's good. So, did you hear about the show at the Tate?
No.
Oh, my God. They're hanging trash in the hallways. I mean, reams and reams of trash.
They do it on purpose?
I'm intrigued, aren't you?
I'm intrigued by who would pay to see it.
And what about our young friend here?
He's my house guest.
Well, is he interested in art?
Oh, yeah. He wishes to be painter.
Old-fashioned or progressive? Classical or progressive?
Well, do I really have to label it?
Oh, just label it, just for the sake of discussion.
See, that's the thing. I'm not trying to be rude here. I don't know if I really can label it.
Oh, come on. Give it a try.
All right, do you hear the rain? It's hitting the roof. It's hitting the window. There's thunder. I think about that, and that's a moment passing in time. Okay, it only exists right now. And then after that exists in our memory.
I find peace in that. I like to capture things like that. I don't like painting an image that is just being painted for image's sake. I'm sorry, does that make any sense?
Yeah. Shared experience, it makes sense, yes.
But it's still representational, right?
Well, yeah, I guess.
Well, now I'm just curious. I mean, what would prevent you from breaking through that? I mean, is it fear?
Fear of what?
Digging deeper?
I'm sorry, I'm not sure what you mean.
Well, representational is safe.
Oh, it's safe? How do you figure that?
It uses symbols.
Every single time you pick up a brush, you're creating symbols.
Well, that's true, actually.
Not to mention, I mean, representational art is highly underrated right now. I mean, that's far from safe, don't you think?
My God, you two are peas in a pod.
What do you think?
I need you to wallpaper a bedroom. Say something of great importance to you. That's why you stare. Let's go.
Well, I think we're done. Don't get up. It's all right. Oh, shit.
Oh, come on, I'm not that bad.
No, it's not what I meant,
Yeah, no, I get it. Is Nikolai here? I'll just put this here.
If you want, I could wake him up if you want.
No, normally I do that. We'll make us some coffee.
All right.
So, are you the fix-it man?
No.
No? So who are you?
Well, I'm an artist.
You're an artist?
Yeah.
You don't sound so sure about that.
Well, yeah, I am.
You must have some talent. Nikolai doesn't take on any students.
Oh, well, right now I'm just sort of fixing up the place.
So then you are the fix-it man.
No.
Oh, I heard voices.
Nikolai. Oh!
That's so nice. Go push my bed back against the wall. Let me see. Oh, wonderful. Getting younger and younger. I'm older and older. Thank you for that.
Of course. Apple?
Why don't you go move the bed, you little shit?
Oh, I'm rushing. Look at me. Order kids around. I'm great.
So I narrowed it down to these.
This one?
Well,
show me another one.
I like this one, but I'm a girl, Nikolai.
I know that.
You do?
Yeah. What's up?
Nothing.
Do you need anything right now? Show me.
But if we do this one, I think your house is gonna look a little too feminine, don't you?
I don't know.
No?
I put the dirt in it.
I thought about this one.
Thank you so much. The apple pie was delicious.
More next week?
Thank you.
Nice meeting you, John.
Thanks for your pie.
That's a woman.
She's pretty incredible.
Women are such delightful creatures, aren't they?
To be quite honest, I really don't have much experience with them, but... Are you two,
Oh, don't be crazy. We just understand one another.
Shared experience.
I suppose you can say that. It's where he says she lost her son. Some drunk idiot ran them off the road. She reminds me a bit of my Anya, you know. My Anya. She was beautiful and smart. Huh. Not too smart, she married me. She taught at the same university where I taught painting.
What happened?
She's gone. It's very simple. We pick a woman because we think she's perfect. They pick us because they wish to make us perfect. Hmm? In your 20s, you look back on much of what I told you and shake your head, crazy old bastard. In your 30s, little bits will come back like an echo. By the time you're 50, you'll say, this old Russian fuck was right about a lot of things. Keep laughing, you idiot.
Sunday was a big night for Serov. He would start cooking the evening meal early in the morning.
There's spiders down here.
After the dinner, which seemed to go on for hours, Nikolai and Curtis would sit around and get drunk and have the same discussion they'd been having for years.
There is a place, I suppose, for representational art. You know, just as there is a place, I suppose, for the old school wanting to pass down conventional training methods to the new school, but strictly for archival reasons, you know, historical reasons, to point out where art once was as opposed to where it's headed to.
Which is a crapper. Sorry, son.
Don't worry, Nikolai. After all these years, I'm used to it from both of you.
What about you? What do you think?
Well, he understands the modern movement more than I do.
Well, she appreciates it, you know, on an intrinsic level, but... I mean, let's face it, she has a degree in psychology, not in art history, and you know that, Nikolai.
I think that's madness.
And what is that, my friend?
That you need a doctorate to appreciate painting. I mean, you don't need a diploma to appreciate music.
Well, art has moved from what was once a communication to the masses to what it is now, which is a communication to a far more select few.
And when did this happen? You're just as much a member of the masses as he, she, farmer down the road.
Farmer down the road has far different interests than you and I.
But art is a common ground. When you, Sandra, John, me, farmer down the road, take a pause for one moment and appreciate something that connects us all. This is beauty of being alive. This is art. Art that divides us is not art.
Well, that is very sentimental, Nikolai.
You say sentimental like it's venereal disease. I say something funny. What's wrong with sentiment?
It has no place in art.
Says who?
Oh, come on, Nikolai. I mean, sentiment is a sloppy, sugary, emotional form of gushing, which is indicative of a lack of intellect.
You have so much intellect. that you've become stupid, Curtis. The sentiment is common decency. Is being a human being, is knowing that life is short. It's very, very short. I know it in my age. This is a sentiment. I'm proud of it. It's what you have done with that word that I find so utterly disturbing. To cry, to hurt, to ponder, to love, really love something. These are the building blocks of our humanity. It's what builds bridges. Creates Rembrandt, Van Gogh, Monet, Renoir. What you are talking about creates unrest, disturbance, misery, mess, fucking mess. Sorry.
It's okay.
Well, what I'm talking about is a far different sector of the human condition.
But it has no place in fucking art.
And what about the man in the ghetto, Nikolai? I mean, where is the conventional beauty in his existence?
You know about ghetto as much as I know about building fucking a rocket ship. I think there must be some beauty in ghetto. Too many brilliant minds have been born in ghetto. If one needs to find beauty there, it is the people who come from there, not some rich fucking asshole who knows nothing about ghetto, saying, ah, poor man from ghetto. I know your pain, I know everything about it. I feel so sorry. You know what it is? This is bullshit. This is fucking bullshit. Sorry.
It's okay.
Well, thank you, Nikolai, for another wonderful and stimulating evening.
All right, Curtis. We solve problems of the world together next time.
It's a date, my friend.
Okay. Good night, beautiful Sandra.
Thank you.
Good night.
Good night.
Fucking asshole.
I just can't remember the last time it was this hot in August. I mean, I hope it doesn't affect the turnout, really? Don't you? Oh, here he is, our man of the hour, Nikolai Serov. Please say hello to our friend and hostess, Miss Sally Huntington Quayle.
It's an honor to have you judging our exhibit, Mr. Serov.
Pleasure's all mine. Nikolai, please. Beautiful sunrise.
Hello, Nikolai.
Oh, yes, it's all just waiting for you, Nikolai.
What the fuck is this?
You're Nikolai Serov.
Yeah, is this yours?
Oh, yeah.
What's the point?
Mechanized madness.
You've half succeeded.
Sir, would you like some wine? You want the vodka?
Sir.
You didn't take the whole thing? Some spades and rock and rollers, you're all the same. My match your instrument, I felt so ashamed.
You're the artist?
Yes, sir.
What's the point?
Well, see, I'm exploring the two-dimensionality of the canvas.
You mean its flatness?
Well, yes.
But it's already fucking flat. What's there to explore?
Yes, but to explore that flatness.
I'm lost.
Well, you see, it's a journey that I take.
A journey?
Yes, the exploration of what the thing already is.
Which is flat.
Yes.
So, where do you come in?
I explore that.
What it is already?
Yes.
Do you understand?
No.
Watching Nikolai in this room was like watching Marilyn Monroe at a freak show. Being outnumbered, she had suddenly become the freak.
Can I get you anything?
Can of gasoline, Sir Mattress.
Why, are we having a good time?
Having a good time? Having a good time. Oh, yes, I'm having a good time. No. I'm telling you, if I live another 10 more years, I will live to see Bucket of Piss in Museum of Modern Art. Please give me
Let's get home. Let's...
Nikolai.
You know, people are all crazy. All crazy. So, I see all this shit. It's all shit. You know, people, you see shit. It's all shit. Shit! Shit! There's a war going on here of craziness and sanity. And craziness is winning. Craziness is winning.
Let's get
this is the only fucking thing. Only fucking thing that works in this room. That's it. Congratulations! What the hell is this?
I don't even know anymore. I tried to get the house, and then I wanted a tree. Change perspective.
What was your first idea?
I don't even know.
If you have no idea, how the fuck am I supposed to know? What you are trying to tell me?
I had a good idea. I sort of lost it.
No. You never had a good idea. Good idea doesn't get lost. You know, Monet could paint his house with broom, bucket of shit. It's harder to drive a car than to paint a picture. I want you to listen to me very closely. And never forget what I'm going to tell you.
Okay.
Never forget. Rajatapa! Tachipa! To prichapa!
I didn't understand one word of that. You were just making weird noises.
Because I'm not speaking clearly. I'm not saying anything. And that's what this shit looks like you keep producing. First thing, get an idea. Oh, my date has arrived.
Can you do me a favor? Can you not yell at me in front of her?
Sure. You got it.
Hey, guys.
Hey, Carla. Oh, brownie.
Wonderful. What are you doing?
Just learn to speak clearly.
It's interesting.
I wasn't clearly speaking. Yeah. People learning.
How are we today?
Freaking idiot. I wasn't learning.
Nikolai taught art therapy at a local school for special kids. It was good to see this side of him. What a kind man he really could be. And he really seemed to care a great deal. The other teachers at the school all said that Serov was their favorite guest.
Take a little bit more water. A little bit more water here in this area. Try it. Oh, a big red heart with a face. And here a lot of birds, yes? Sense to me than that fucking Curtis Sunday. You know, I think they're ready to paint in oils.
Nice.
Thank you.
Here.
Oh.
In case you get thirsty.
Thanks, thanks again. Hey, I wanted to say thank you and give you your cup back.
Thanks.
You all right? It's not very convincing. You sure?
I'm just having a crummy day.
Well, why don't you allow me to cheer you up a bit? You know, when I'm having a crummy day, I like nice hot cocoa. Talk about it with a friend. Huh? Want some cocoa? I got nothing but time. I can't go paint now. Stupid clouds keep moving. I'm making you feel a little bit better?
Yes. You are.
If you want to talk about anything, we can.
No. Not especially.
How about I talk for a while? Why is Sarah being such an asshole? I swear, he's constantly in a bad mood, drinking. I'm pretty sure he hates me.
If he hated you, you'd be very sure.
Are you telling me that this is the nicest he gets?
Has he told you about his wife?
Oh, a little.
Has he told you how she died?
No.
She was killed in Russia during Stalin's occupation in something they called the purges. He was the only one in his family to get out. That kind of guilt never leaves you.
Then again, if you think about it, he really didn't do anything wrong.
Sure he did. He survived.
Yeah. Help me cut the vegetables as well.
All right. Why are you doing up so early?
It's going to be a wonderful party tonight.
Are you happy right now? Is this you being happy?
Cut pieces smaller. All I want them to melt.
Okay. Oh, wait, you are happy right now, aren't you?
Yeah, why not? Can't a man be happy? Young John is coming along very well, very well with his studies.
Oh, that's wonderful, Nikolai, and John. But now, what about that work you promised me?
You're anxious, aren't you?
Well, hell yes.
I'll go and get it.
How's your dad? Didn't you
enjoy it? Here it is. He's a progressive artist. Not really my cup of tea, but I'm anxious to hear what you have to say. This one.
Holy shit.
You don't like it? Shut up. You see, no, I think it's like, yes, that's. So, what do you think?
What do you think, honey?
It's not my area of expertise, sweetheart.
Well, we know that, but thoughts? Share?
I think I'll just stick to being a shrink.
Oh, come on now. Take a position. What about depth?
All right, it has depth.
Depth? It's fucking deep!
Yes, it's fucking deep.
My God. Let me see the next one, Nikolai.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God, there is so much pain.
Pain?
Yeah, the angularity of, of line.
Mm-hmm.
And despair, a deep sense of despair and,
Yeah.
There's a yearning, a deep sense of yearning.
Yearning, yes.
And there's sadness. Sadness over rage. It's just an emotional yin and yang, don't you think, honey?
Absolutely.
I mean, you gotta see this, Nikolai. You do see the sadness.
Oh, yes, I think it's very, very sad.
It takes my breath away. I've got to meet this guy. This is quite a... More. I want to see more.
Oh, yes, please. This one. I like this.
It's almost as if there are several styles at work here. If I didn't know better, I would think that there was more than one hand at work, and yet... And yet there is an overriding theme. It's a passive impression of, dare I say... Pointlessness.
Yeah. Pointlessness.
The artist is clearly expressing through a means of minimalism a simplistic rendering of essentials. It's got weight, it's got focal point, it's got secondary thought. I mean, and it's completely cohesive in its intent.
And you see all of this in two blue squares and crooked tree?
It's impossible not to see. I mean, it's so fucking clear.
Yeah. Fucking clear. I will tell you what's fucking clear. It's how full of shit you are.
Oh, come on, Nikolai. I mean, you said this was not your cup of tea. This artist is clearly brilliant, and I think maybe we're a little jealous.
These paintings are from the fucking retarded kids that I teach at the school.
What?
Brilliance, simplicity, yearning, you know? God, that's bullshit. Bullshit.
Nikolai, this is not funny.
I think it's fucking hysterical.
You know what? I'm not staying for coffee.
Oh, no, please stay. I have a wonderful painting of Big Red Car. See the girl.
Get your wrap. We're leaving, honey.
Curtis, I have a wonderful painting of Turtle Dog. See, what do you think? Is it beautiful?
That's enough.
Wait, I have a wonderful painting. I mean, that's a masterpiece of two orange mice. It has balance. Hey,
you know what, Nikolai? You have really, really lost your mind this time.
I've lost my mind. I've lost my mind.
And what is so damn funny?
I've lost my mind.
Would you stop with that fucking laughing?
I've lost my mind.
Good morning.
What? What is?
Nothing. I just want to see if possibly you could teach me to paint today.
What? Paint? Yes. Paint's a fucking cellar. I found hornet's nest up in it.
That's nice. Why don't you take your sneakers for a walk, all right? I've been out here for 2 hours now. I'm finally getting somewhere.
Sun has already moved in 2 hours.
I know that, but I would like to finish this painting.
Go kill hornets.
Why can't you do it yourself?
Don't you think I'm too old to be up on a ladder?
You don't need a ladder. Go up there and tell them how great you are. They'll fall right out.
What did you say, you little shit?
You heard me just fine, all right? The deal was I come up here and you teach me how to paint. Now fix up your fucking house.
Oh, some passion here. Not this my daddy doesn't understand me bullshit.
And exactly what do you know about my father?
Oh, what do I know about him? He thinks I'm old Russian commie faggot. You shouldn't summer with him. All he wants is a little piece of chicken chicken.
I'll have another fucking drink.
You want your lesson for the day? I'll show you. Sky color first. Everything reflects sky. Even through this.
What the?
Everything.
The fuck is that? No, that's fucking nice. Thanks a lot.
Ah, you probably improved it.
Fuck you.
Fuck me.
Yeah, fuck you, Nikolai.
What would you like for dinner? How about I make fish? I'm tired of beef. No, the hornets are waiting.
You gotta be fucking kidding me. Come on, wake up. Wake up, come on. Come on, I'm hungry.
Yeah, it just...
Can't tell.
It opened up as I was walking across the field.
You want me to go get you a towel?
That would be nice.
All right, go ahead and put these away.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm dripping everywhere.
Oh. So is painting what you want to do? I mean, is that what you want to do for a living?
I don't know, you know, I've never really thought about it as making money, you know what I mean? I know that I have a love for it, I know that I have a passion for it, and just talking about it gets me excited. There's this place in New York City called Grand Central Art Galleries, and I'll go in there and spend hours of just looking at these beautiful paintings, and I'll be looking at them, and I'll literally feel my heart just starting to beat faster. I mean, I don't understand how they do it. You get 2 inches away from the painting, all you see is brush strokes, technique, and paint. And 10 feet back, you see this beautiful painting. It makes you really almost feel the wind blowing through the trees or the ocean air. God. I don't know how people can do that. It's inside me somewhere. You know, it's fighting to get out.
You'll do it.
Mm.
distracted a lot too. You know, there's a lot of things that I love. Love to tell stories, make people laugh. I love music.
Do you play anything?
Yeah, guitar and sax.
So you're a real Renaissance man.
I don't know, I guess. I mean,
you always sound like you're apologizing. You have it tough at home, don't you? Whatever it is that's going on there, don't worry about it. You'll be okay.
Thanks. I think Eli told me what happened to your son. I was wondering, is that why you take care of him, Nikolai?
Something like that.
Where's your husband?
I was never married. I just got pregnant.
Is the father around at all? Hey, listen. I know that you feel guilty, but you shouldn't, you know? I mean, you didn't do anything wrong.
You're a sweet young man, John. Don't let anyone ever talk you out of what you want to do, who you want to be. Follow your heart.
Thank you. I tried to wake you up. You were out cold. I should probably walk you home.
Good night, Nikolai.
Good night.
Understand.
She's my friend. My friend. Not yours.
I'm sorry.
I bet you are.
You're right, I'm not sorry.
I want you out of here.
It's fine.
You come into my life and turn it upside down like this. How dare you?
You fucking lied to me.
No, I didn't lie. I've been helping you. But you're too young. Too stupid. To see the gifts I've been giving you. All the gifts. I want you out of here. Tonight.
All right, I'll fucking go. You go crawl into your fucking bottle. Go feel sorry for yourself.
You don't get it. You just don't get it. I'm at the end of my life, and all I see coming is one big fucking abyss.
I'm at the beginning of my life, and I see the same fucking thing. You had the world by the balls for 5 minutes. I don't know if I'm any good. I don't know shit. I can't even go home.
I don't care. Nobody cares. That's what I've been trying to tell you all along. The world is too fucking ugly. They killed. I killed the most beautiful thing I'd ever seen. My Anya. She had a laugh. Like a happy little child. I remember her laugh. I thought I would never be a part of the kind of ugliness that took her from me. I knew you had something. Before I even saw your paintings. And you were babbling on my front porch, remember? But you'd be crazy to become painter today. There are no heroes. No Van Gogh, no Rembrandt, no Monet, no Renoir, no nothing.
I was hoping that you'd be mine.
I'm tired. I'm just very, very tired.
Nikolai? Come on, man. Let's go get some breakfast. Nikolai?
Today, we paint.
We took to the fields that morning. He was like a different person.
Laying out your pellet should always be the same. Your colors are like the keys to a piano. Musician must always have them in the same place, you know, to express themselves. Great painter does the same thing.
He showed me everything and more, opened up a floodgate of knowledge. A lifetime of secrets rushed forward like a mountain stream.
Sun is like a woman when she kisses the land with warm lips. She leaves a little color everywhere.
I began to see yellows, ochres, oranges, reds everywhere.
And wherever there's a warm, there's a cool. It's the opposite of the warm. Not only in temperature of color, but the opposite of the color on the color scale. Where there's yellow, there's purple. Grass is green everywhere. That white fence becomes pink. Understand?
It was amazing what he could do. In just a few seconds, he could turn something flat into something that seemed alive.
Now you have to find a way to bring it to life, the whole thing. To feel the joy.
He showed me how to get a sky to vibrate.
Oh, bravo, John. Bravo. This is life. I feel the shadows. I feel the sun here coming out. The joy of it all. Bravo, John.
I have to thank you for the time we shared together.
I really should be thanking you.
No. You gave me a glimpse of something I never thought I'd see again.
Thank you, Nikolai.
Thank you. I mean, say goodbye to girlfriend, don't you think?
Oh, I mean, she's not really my girlfriend, Nikolai.
Leave a note, nice letter, something like this. Huh? Good. I'm waiting here. Go.
Dear Carla, you were right. I was lost. But finding my way has never been so sweet or rewarding. Your words will always stay with me. Find your dreams too. Love always. John.
Just put all your bags upstairs.
Thanks. Where are you off to?
I don't know. Gotta figure that one out.
Good luck.
I went to the park and sketched for hours, rehearsing what I was going to say to my parents. Finally, I decided it would be best to just face them. Let the chips fall where they may.
Salud.
Nastrovia. We really had a good time, yes.
Well, that's great. I'm glad to hear that.
We were just talking about
you. Hey, your friend Nikolai's a good guy.
Yeah, he is.
He was telling me about the good times that you both had. I'm glad you're home.
Oh, thanks.
Oh. You told me that you met a girl?
Yeah?
I did. You want a drink?
Please.
Come on.
Yeah, I would.
Come on.
It's good to see you.
Hey, honey!
It's good. He came, your teacher. To see your father, I mean. Did you learn anything?
Yeah, Mom. Learned a lot.
Good.
To this day, I have no idea what Nikolai said to straighten things out. But either way, it didn't matter. My father and I never talked about the events of that summer ever again. I never went to college. I studied at the museum instead. Mostly art. But I minored in life.
I can't get this thing out.
No, you do.
I'm lousy at
little
this.
Little bits.
I know, little bits. I can't get this thing out here.
Like that.
He's the artist. He's the one who should be doing this.
Yeah.
Where the hell are you going?
I'm just going to drop off a present to Nikolai real quick.
You said you're going to help me shovel the driveway.
I am. I'm just going to do it when I get back.
Huh. All right. Well, be careful. There's a lot of ice out there on the road. Drive safe.
All right.
Look at your mom. Look how pretty your mom looks. Look at you. Come here, you beautiful girl.
Sweet.
Nikolai!
That's how I'd like to remember him. His brush dancing across the canvas like a ballerina dancing across a stage. I'd like to tell you that Nikolai lived many more years. That I'd given him some kind of gift or remembrance of what he once was. But I think that'd be too big an assumption for me to make. And perhaps a bit of a lie. Nikolai passed away that spring. With his passing, a part of me died along with him. I gave up painting for several years. Thank you. I heard later that he gave the house to Carla. She designed most of it anyway, and I think they both knew it was going to end up that way. Other interests would lead me west. But the older I got, the more Nikolai's thoughts came back to guide me, and all the gifts he'd given me. I still see trees as rooted men. Or nudes dancing on a hillside. Or the clouds as a place where angels hide. It took me years to realize that Nikolai wasn't really gone. That all this time he was still here, living inside of me, patiently waiting to take the journey shared. But most of all for me, to keep a promise that I made to myself a very long time ago. That Nikolai's heart would be my home all the days of my life.